Hello and welcome back again with another episode of LabShow for C programmers. And in this session we are going to have a look at the if functions and related to that the switch statement. Just start with a very simple example in C. First we have a function which is going to calculate if we return the largest of A and B. A simple function, two inputs A and B. When A is bigger than B, it will return A, and otherwise it will return B. Now let's make the same thing from scratch. I will drag in again the known panels, the front panel and the code panel. Here we can see our function definition, and the front panel is more or less the same as a normal function definition. So what I will do is I will make first two controls. One I will call A, and I will make the representation an integer. I will now take a copy of it. In fact, I made a signed integer, but that doesn't really care matter. And I will make the return value as well. Largest. And these two are all controls now, and control means that they are inputs, and this one has to become, of course, the output. So what I will do, I will change this to an indicator, and you can see the border in the diagram changes slightly, and now this is an output. What I can do now is I can start my if statement. With the LabShow, there is not really an if statement, but you have only the case structure. Which is similar like the switch statement from C. So I will select the case structure, and now I will get a box which has a true and a false value. Now I have to make a comparison between those two, and I will use the greater function. I will wire everything up. And I will wire this one and this one as well to the input of the to the case structure, which is now has only two values, so it's like an if statement. What I will do if the result is true, I will put A out, and if the boolean is false, I will return B. So what I've done, I have now made the if statement, the same program you see here. This is the comparison. A bigger than B is done here. Then I get my if statement, which in this case is this box. If the statement is true, I will return the value A. And if the statement is false, I will return the value B. One of the nice things you can do with LabShow is that you can do very simple unit testing. So normally if you would have something like this, you would have to make your own code to fill in A or B. Within LabShow, I can just run this program, this function, simply by pressing the continuous run button. And now I can just click and add values. And of course this looks like some kind of user interface, but in this case you should not look at it as a user interface, but just as the function header and integrated test functionality. And you can see now if I put in here, if I click some values, if I make this one 2, it will return the largest value. I can switch on syntax highlighting, and you will see everything happening. So what you see is you get the wire, and on the wire the value is also shown. So if I now make B 6, you will see that A and B will become false, A bigger than B will become false, and it will run the false statement. Again, what you see here is the data flow programming. The wires, you should consider the variables, and you will see that there are some wires here, and if in fact every wire will be a copy of the data. So the moment I enter the case structure, a copy will be made, and here again a copy will be made. In fact, there may be some optimizations, but for now consider this to be true. I will come back to that later. So this is more or less what you get. So we have two cases. In the true case, I will pass through A. In the false case, I will pass through B. And this is maybe a little bit tricky for you to see, but in fact, these two are the same wire. Yeah. Now what you will get frequently is an if, else, and another else if statement. And we can do the same in LabVIEW. So in this case, I've made a function largest tree, where I also add C. And I just make a concatenated if statement with an else if. Just pause the video now so you can see yourself what it's doing, if you like. And in the meanwhile, I will adapt the program to include this new functionality. So now we have the true statement will still be the same, it will return largest. But in false, we will have to do a new comparison. So what I will do now is I will make another comparison to see if B is bigger than C. I will now add another case structure, and I will do exactly the same, where I will return B if B is bigger than C, and I will return C if it's not the case. And what you will now see is that I will have a case structure with an if statement within the other if statement. And this looks a little bit different than you are used to, because normally you would see everything in one line and you can just read through the text. And in this case, you have to browse through the different cases. But yeah, in fact, it's a way of getting used to. This has its drawbacks. It's not immediately obvious what all the states are, but it also has a big benefit. For example, if I would make a small bug in this program, if I just would remove this else, I get a completely different function. In this case, with the graphical programming, it is impossible to make such a same mistake. You can make this code, of course, as well, but this code is something completely different than this code. And these kind of things can happen in C, and they are nearly impossible in LabVIEW. Again, I can run the program in a debug mode, and I can now make another one. The largest, you will see some delay because it has to go first through here. And probably I made a small mistake. A, B bigger than, it's just a slight delay, Okay, I can run it at full speed and then it goes a little bit faster. And it will update automatically in real time, Okay, so this is how you do an else if sequence, and some benefits and some drawbacks. But as already mentioned, there is not really an if statement. Everything is a switch statement, and that's also the reason why it's called a case structure. So I will just go to the next example, which is some kind of simple calculator function. We have an input A and input B, and we have an operator, and if the operator is 0, we will add the two values. If it's 1, we subtract the two values, and if it's 2, we will make a logical AND. We store the result in X, and if X is, and X is returned in this case. Now let's start from scratch. Again, I will add two controls. A, I will make representation an unsigned integer, 32-bit. I will make a B, and I will also make an op for operator. And I will create a change to indicator. I will make this one X. Now I will again draw the same case structure, which defaults to true and false. But now if I take the selection terminal and wire an integer to it, you will see that the selection mechanism changes from true or false to 0, default, and 1. If I select 0, this will be my 0 case. And in the 0 case, I can add the two values. I will add the two values. I will duplicate this case to make case 1. It now selects automatically a value. I will replace it by 1. I will replace this one by subtract. There is a second one which was automatically generated, but I forgot to delete. And I just want to copy now everything, so I will delete this one. Again, I will duplicate the case and I will change this one to a logical end. And now you will see a broken arrow here instead of a normal arrow, and that means that there is a syntax error. So if you would have the same in C and you would compile it, you will get a compile error. Then you get the line and you have to check what's going on. But in this case, I forgot to specify the default case. So I have an integer as selector and I can have multiple inputs. I can have 0, 1, 2, but of course I can have all other values. So what I will do is I will add a case after and I will call this one the default case. And now you will still see a broken error, and that's because I didn't connect anything to this terminal. I can now either create a constant and set it to 0, like this. But I can also do something else. I can say, okay, use default if unwired. And that means in case of an integer, it will become 0. The default values are specified within the language. Now you will see the arrow has become runnable again. So I can now start and I will switch on syntax highlighting and you will see some things happening. Operation is 0, so you will see automatically case 0 and the result of course will also be 0. I can just add two values here and now this should become 6. If I would now select operation value 1, you will see that the two are subtracted. And if I would make it 2, you can see here as again, and it will go to the end statement. And if I make this 3, we will get 2, hopefully. Ah, that's great. Yeah. Okay. Well, this is more or less the switch statement, which is the case structure. I will elaborate a little bit more on this later, because I will show you now quickly. The case structure has many other options. For example, I could make a string control, which is just I show you hello world, for example. So here I have a string. It's duplicated here. And instead of just having true and false, I can also add strings to the same thing. So now if the string would be hello world, I will end the two values. And in if it's 0, I will do the add. If it's the string has the value 1, I will subtract them. And if it's another value, I will subtract, will return 0. So now if I run it, I will switch off this one. We will see hello world. If I make the string value 0, you will see it's being added. If I make the string value 1, they are subtracted. And if I make something else, you will see the value 0 being returned. So this is the case structure, which is the multiple out version of the if statement and everything you would like to see. Now, there's one last one we'll have to look at, and this is of course the cheap version of the if statement, where you just say a question mark and some semicolon. We can do the same within LabVIEW. So again, I will put in a control A. I will make a control and call it B. I will do it a little bit different this time. Again, I will In this case, I will use floats, which is double position. And here I have another way. This is like the question mark. I can say, okay, if it's true, I will continue with that one. In the other case, I will continue with the other one. And I will make this one return. And you even saw the initial label, which does exactly the same. It already points you. For not C programmers, this will be very complicated to understand. But this is the known switch statement. If it's true, it will return the value true. And if it's false, it will return the value false. And this is more or less like the statement. And you can see here also the origins of FlapView, which in fact are mostly C. This is 4. And this is 6. So you can see it's working. Well, thank you for watching. A little bit longer than 10 minutes to explain the if statement, but I hope you can continue with your investigation of FlapView this way. Bye.